Morning. I was looking through my collection of photographs and I came up with this one I did several months ago, a couple of months ago, probably. It's a moorland scene. I'll just zoom you in on it. I like this sort of view. I like painting it. I like bleak landscape. I think I got a derogatory comment on this and several others that I've done, and I stopped the person from commenting. If people don't like my work, they don't have to watch it. There's plenty of people better than me. But anyway, I like it, and I'm going to do a version of it again. It won't look the same, but for the moment, I'm just a bit of a loss of what to do this morning, so I want to do at least one video today. Right, okay, so let's zoom out and back to there. My usual procedure here, wet the paper all over. I'll just get my palette out. It's in this Ziploc bag, it's been languishing overnight. So we've got lemon yellow, raw sienna, alizarin crimson, light red, ultramarine, burnt umber, paint grey and burnt sienna. As you can see, the paint is very liquid or very moist because I gave it a good spray with this thing before I put it to bed. It keeps the paint nice and moist, but not so moist that it's slipping all over the place. It's a bit of a compromise between the tablets of colour and tube paint. Now tube paint is lovely to work with, but it's quite wasteful. But using it like this and keeping it moist, it's a good compromise. I owe that to Maria Kellner, so thanks Maria. I know you watch all my videos. So, the 2-inch hake, or slightly less than 2 inches. Give it the paper a bit of a wet. The water's not, I haven't changed it since yesterday, but it doesn't matter. So I'll make the horizon a bit higher maybe. We'll see how we can fill in the landscape. It's just an impression of moorland really. There aren't any moors near where I live. There's the River Wandle and there's Mitcham Common and there's Oaks Park. All very nice places. But nothing bleak, I'm afraid. Not in suburbia. Right, so I'll put a bit of raw sienna over all of it. Just to warm it up and give it a bit of a unifying wash. Bit of burnt sienna in as well, why not? Now, I'm not... This one, I'm using three hakes and they all seem to have their idiosyncrasies. They split into their clumps, which is a bit of a nuisance. Right, we'll put in a bit of a blue with some alizarin. The ultramarine blue, which I love, is my main colour. But with a little bit of alizarin in it, it just takes a little bit of that brilliant blue out of it. Right, now we'll mix a bit of light red in with that to make a bit of a cloud colour. Put it on the red side. You've got a nice bit of movement on that. Okay, let's just get that over there like that. Right, let's reclip the paper. And then we'll give it a bit of a dry. Take the shine off the paper a little bit. So take your headphones off if you're listening on headphones. I remember I got a complaint from somebody whose ears were blasted apart when I didn't warn her. So I try to remember to warn people now. So with that, these colours, there's a bit of alizarin in there, a bit of sienna. See, that's muddy. Right. Bit of a... some different colours in with this. So normally we use blue to give the impression of distance, but we can work in some blue in that. Okay, so that's a bit of a background. I would put a bit of lemon yellow in. Bit of sienna as well. A bit of burnt sienna, just to warm that up a little bit. There's some lovely moors in Cornwall, Devon, Bodmin, Exmoor, Dartmoor, marvellous. A bit of Payne's grey now, make a nice bit of yellow. So do you need to vary the colours in all this? It avoids it getting a bit monotonous. I'm going to put rocky tors in, and tors, T-O-R-S. Just mixing up different bits of green. And then we'll go with a nice yellow now. You need a bit of rag by your right knee or left knee, just to take any excess moisture off the brush. These are just background colours. We'll go for an umbrella over there, why not? Plenty of colour. And maybe a bit of a path. Right, that's too flat now, a bit of dark. Just the background, and we're going to superimpose some colour and detail over this. Loads of colour, a warm colour, reds in with the burnt sienna. Okay, so we need to start to texture this now with some trees, stunted trees, gorse, stuff like that. A bit of blue. Bit of sienna, burnt sienna that is, and a bit of yellow. Good, solid, strong trees. The burnt sienna, bit of Payne's grey, nice dark with this hill. And load of lovely rich colour in there. And I'll use a card and I'll just start to flick out some. And we'll put a few little rocks in here and there. Okay, that'll do. It's just a more of these. I'll put some darker chunks in and branches if I remember a bit later on. But very little detail in that, a bit of distance there. Let's get a nice, good, strong dark here. Okay, we'll do a bit here, loads to do in there. Tiny bit of water in the mix here. Payne's grey, lemon yellow. I can put some figures on that path. That should, with a bit of luck, say, oh, this is a path. No, a bit of blue, a bit of red. I can write mess with my palette here. I don't want too much sparkle in this. Dark. Which I'm going to etch in some rocks and stuff in this. Some blue, red. Just a tangle of the foliage here. Right, here's my card. I'll change the card to this one. Right. Haven't done much scraping out for a while. I do enjoy it. Very easy to overdo it, and I love overdoing it. So let's put in some. Not exactly a wall, but see if I can put some. I'm going to put some heavier green on top of that there, to take it up a little bit higher. I can put some detail on there, some dark trunks. It's a lovely dark with Payne's grey and burnt sienna. Very rich. Okay. We need to do a bit on this middle distance now. So we'll lighten the colour. Let's add some blue. think I've got a bit heavy there. We're sort of close to the middle of the. I'm going to have to drag the interest away from there a little bit, I think. To here. So we can just etch out some bits and pieces here. Small. Some blue now. Okay. Now some lighter, very light stuff now. Just some flora fauna and something on here. So there's a lot of farmers on the moors in England, and walls, and it's although it's very can be very bleak. So I've got a prison. Well, I had a prison on Dartmoor. That it's all cultivated. There's very little that man hasn't had a finger in. There's some trees on there. Blue. Just little flicks and touches. Leave lots of stuff to imagination. Okay, that'll do. Now we're down to the rigger now. Just some bits sticking up there. Don't know if that will show, when it dries, I don't know if it will show too much, but just to balance the, I've overdone the scraping as you can see there. So let's just rough it up a little bit. And some over here. More or less neat Payne's Grey, whoops, Payne's Grey here. Figures. what colour is going to show up? I'll use a blue and a red. Not really going to show up there, are they? I should have. I think I'll make his head a bit bigger, just make his body a little bit bigger. Okay, just about shows. Right, well, I don't think they're particularly brilliant, are they? But I should have left a bit of light behind their heads. They've had a bit more impact. But anyway, they're figures, and so we've given them a bit of shadow, a bit of shadow. Okay, let's put a few birds in. Signature. Right, put that in a blue mount, I think. So I haven't done the tours, but I'll put the rocks in here, just how it panned out in the time I've got available. So. Right, okay, let's have a look at that. Well, that's not too bad. So, out on the moors. I could, I suppose, just put in with my a bit of shade, a bit of dark rock in there so while I see it. That might be a little bit improved there. Get the shadows. Okay, get in there. Okay, what does that do? So there we are. Oops, an English moor. Moorland. Put the clips on just to hold the mount flat. Okay, so I'll bring you around and we'll have a little look at this. No great care It was just made up as we went along, as the brush found its marks, or place to put the marks. And just from the start of the distance there, I've just indicated fields on the fertile parts of the hills where the rocks aren't too close to the surface. And I've given you a bit of distance, but I've used bright colour there with a bit of blue to suggest the distance. Now we come down to this mess of shrubbery here, trees and nondescript stuff, and so those rocks, and the figures. Well, he looks a very old man, didn't he, at the back? Is that me? All right, okay, so there we are. I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.